Oh my god, hi!
Disco, say hi!
Hi, Disco!
Hey, what's up?
Oh, wow.
Okay, now I'm aroused. I didn't expect to start the interview that way. Hello, I'm Harriet Rose and welcome to Heat. Are You Watching? The show that dives into the hottest TV that everyone is talking about. And this week, it is, of course, UK Drag Race. Say that I'm excited is a drastic understatement. Never watched Drag Race? You sicken me. Here's a quick lowdown. Season 2 has been trending every Thursday since it started in January. It brought the joy we needed in those dark lockdown months. After 10 glorious weeks of RuPaul's challenges, 12 queens became 4, which was a shock because normally there are 3 finalists. That sums up season 2. It's been drama and so much fun from the start. RuPaul's challenges have been insane. Good to see Alan Carr, Michelle Visage and Graham Norton back as judges. And the guests were next level. Liz Hurley, Emenike, Lorraine Kelly, Dawn French, Jessie Ware. It was chef's kiss. Stick around because we'll be spilling the tea about what went down backstage with Bimini Bon Boulash, Tayce, Lawrence Chaney and Ellie Diamond. So don't go anywhere. As if the show couldn't get any better, Jodie Harsh is joining me in the studio to dissect the drama, the looks, the songs, and the makeup. Oh, the makeup. We'll also get a cheeky interview with the winner of Drag Race UK Series 2. No spoilers, just yet. Shh. Hun, you're not gonna wanna miss it. This is Are You Watching? We were lucky enough to get time with the 4 finalists of Drag Race UK Series 2.
Let's spill the tea.
Please welcome your final 4!
Hey, what's up?
Oh, wow.
Okay, now I'm aroused. I didn't expect to start the interview that way.
Honey.
Did you just orgasm?
Yeah, almost.
Almost.
It's been a long lockdown, hun, I'm not gonna lie.
Right? Tell me about it, Tuts.
I'm fucking so excited, girls, to have you. I'm not gonna lie.
Cannot believe it is here.
I feel like it's gone wider than just queer people now. I feel like all of my mum's friends are watching it and like everyone's debating it. It's like, it's crazy the impact it's having this time.
I mean, we've had some amazing stories on there. We've covered so much amazing ground. We've seen some amazing lip syncs, the looks, the comedy, the people. I mean, come on, crown the season as the best season of all time and let's just get on with it.
Here are your final 4.
Hello, Lawrence Chaney.
All right, RuPaul, how's it hanging?
What would you say is the most iconic moment for you of this series?
Which one? the one I'm most proud of, me sat in a horrible, ugly shirt against a purple background just talking absolute shite. That's what I'm most proud of. You know, I need to don't think about it until you see it and you go, no way did I say that. Oh my God, that's too ridiculous.
I am the Susan Boyle of RuPaul's Drag Race UK.
I'm proud to the shagpipes.
Yes. I'll show you my shagpipes.
I never knew what a bagpipe was, let alone a shagpipe. So it's a learning lesson for all, you know? I can now, you know?
Well, on that note, hun, I just want to check in, you know, Michelle McManus, Susan Boyle, has anyone slid into your DMs? Because you've been shouting out all the iconic Scottish ladies.
Yes. Well, this is the thing. Michelle McManus messaged me after the promo and she said, oh, babe, you know, I'll be tuning in, I'll be watching. And, you know, you go, yeah, right, oh, I will. And then she was like, loved your look. Oh, this is fire. Oh, my God, I could never. And I was like, she's actually a stan. I want to win so I can be like Michelle and be a Scottish person that wins a competition, you know?
We love to see it. And also, we love to see potential Lawrence Chaney, Michelle McManus collab single.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. I mean, it would be number one on iTunes. Well, no, it'd be number 2 on iTunes because the United Kingdom's UK hun would be number 1.
Ding dong, bitches. The baby doll of Dundee has arrived.
I mean, this look right now, I feel like, is your most iconic moment, but I don't know that's...
Oh, scary. Do you like her?
Oh, she's stunning, honey.
My most iconic moment is getting to the top four with no challenge wins. I said to anyone who asked, I went, I don't care what happens as long as I make the top four. And I've done everything in my willpower to get there.
You're obviously pretty legendary with your makeup on the show. And as I've mentioned to you, I'm very, very jealous that you're so much better than me. From what age did you start honing those skills? Because you're still young. So how do you have time?
But I've been doing... Oh, yes, get the iron brew.
Chaney is drinking an iron brew.
Yes. Sorry. She's like that off camera, like... Sorry.
That's for OnlyFans. This is Heats, Are You Watching, hun?
This is only scrans. Yeah.
Only brands. And you just drink brands.
When I started doing drag, I initially didn't think to go, oh, well, I can draw and I can do art, and I'm very good at art and creating things with my hands and painting and stuff like that. I didn't think that I could do that on my face. But when I realized that that's how you do drag, or like that's how you do it, it's just like, it's the same as a blank canvas. Once you block your eyebrows down and put a pale foundation over your face, you have a black canvas to then paint stuff on top of. And I was like, oh, now I know. Here we go. Do you know what I mean? Here we go.
Here it is, snatched and fucking ready to rumble.
Wait, well, hold on, we'll flip the band as well. Oh.
The cheek, the nerve, the gall, the audacity, and the gumption. This doesn't look like Barry Island, but it sure will do. Oi, 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 Savaloy. I'm Tayce, I'm 25, and I'm from Newport.
Hello, 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 hello.
Hi, hun. Love the mask.
Oh, my God. I'm on my way to a little shooty shoot, darling. She's a girl on the go. Do you want this way or this way?
Oh, that would be
That's amazing. Better? Yeah. Okay, gorgeous. Here we go. I love how they're all going to look amazing at home and I am in the car doing business.
There were so many iconic moments. You guys went to the number one on the iTunes chart with UK Hun.
Just a small chart entry, nothing crazy.
We bought Taylor Swift off the number one spot. Tay Tay couldn't even get there.
You know what I mean?
Taylor could Happy never. Taylor could never. Are you going to enter it for Eurovision? Because we need it. We need to not get nil point, huns.
I'd be so down if they wanted us. I mean, I think we'd kill it, to be honest. I mean, we are camp as chips on a hot summer's day. You know what I mean?
Tayce, hun, you gave us a Vegas residency, sweetheart. You should be charging.
Girl, RuPaul, I'm going to send him an invoice for all of these lip syncs because, honey, my back is out of it. I mean, 3 weeks on the row, I mean, come on. Four alone is enough, but three on the trot, I mean, at that point, I was like, girl, just roll up the carpet and push me out. You know what I mean?
I think the best thing for me is that I've seen Tayce perform so much, but they give her two fucking ballads and a Jess Glynn song. It's like, you can't even.
Oh, honestly.
You will take home the crown for Lip Sync Assassin, like, no doubt.
Oh my God, could you imagine? I mean, that would be hilarious. I mean, where Bimini's won 4 times, I've basically lost 4 times.
No such thing as losing. You don't lose, honey. No such thing as losing when you don't lose. Also, you take the crown for everything coming out of your mouth being the best meme that's ever existed. You're basically a thesaurus of memes that haven't been created yet. And she's frozen, so she'll never know that
I've another meme waiting to happen.
So I don't know what it was. I think it was because I was on Primmy Hill.
You're over the hill, hun.
Over the hill, and I'm back to you, boo-boo.
You're like the thesaurus of memes.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, it's just me. I mean, Bimini can vouch for me. Anything, like, it's just me. Like that's why my drag name is just my actual name, Tayce. Like, it is not a character. There's no facade. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I know people do drag for many different reasons. But me, it's just... Me just having fun. Me with a bit of lipstick on, I'm exactly the same in and out of it. Goofy, crazy, chaotic, savage, bougie, ratchet. All of the above, darling.
The nipples are the eyes of the face. I am Bimini Bon Boulash, and I'm East London's plant-based princess.
You know, having conversations, Bimini, like you did on the show about being non-binary, you know, for someone in the community, I learned a lot, but for people who aren't in the community, it's a breath of fresh air of information from people who are non-binary to hear those kind of things on the BBC.
I think it's important to hear it from people who's experienced it, as opposed to like someone who's kind of debating it or debating the existence of people. I think like what was so great about mine and Ginny's conversation is how raw it was. And it was just two people having a conversation. And like, you don't even have to be non-binary to relate to feeling different or feeling excluded or anything. Like, that was ultimately what it's about. And I think that's why people, it was received so well, is because it can relate to anyone. It wasn't just for someone that feels non-binary.
Can you tell me what you are planning with Katie Price? Katie Price?
The Pwicey.
The Pwicey. Is it fragrance range? Is it the massage oil? She loves
it. We're going to be ghostwriting each other's new autobiographies.
My world just imploded, so that's that.
I want to do like a high fashion editorial with Katie Price. I want it to be like we're in like matching Versace outfits or something. I think it would just be iconic.
Maybe get her to feature on the United Kingdom's remix of UK Hun.
I want a collab. I want an actual feature. I want a verse by Katie Price. Release the Pwicey.
Release the Pwicey.
Oh my God, hi.
Disco, say hi.
Hi, Disco. Is this the next member of the United Kingdom, yeah?
Yeah, he's the mascot.
The UKD mascot, yeah.
What a babe.
Bimini babes, how's it going with dismantling the patriarchy? Because I couldn't be more behind you.
Yes.
It's going to happen.
Rock on.
It's happening in the media right now. Everyone that's talking about
it. It's dismantling around us.
Yeah, it's happening. It's been dismantled. Yeah. So I'm very happy that we're doing that. What I think with me, what I like to do is like don't take it seriously. It's like talking about serious issues, but making a lighthearted joke about it. And it kind of makes you laugh, makes you relate to it, and makes you see it in a way that I think is important, rather than kind of intimidate or attack.
And before you go, can you tell me, is there anything that happened behind the scenes, like iconic moments that they didn't air that you can share, spill the tea about?
Tayce shit herself in episode 4.
Okay, you need to take me back to the start.
No, I'm joking.
I didn't. Could you imagine?
So this week, Are You Watching? I have a very special guest. I'm super excited to be in real life with Jodie Harsh.
Hi.
Babe.
Good to be here.
Isn't it nice to just look at another human?
IRL.
IRL, BRB, G2G.
But still quite far apart.
Yeah, I know.
COVID secure.
COVID secure, ready to rumble. Babe, absolutely obsessed with your cameo appearance on RuPaul's Drag Race as DJ extraordinaire.
How fun was that?
Honestly, that challenge was the most absurd challenge of all. So it was the limbo challenge where all the queens apparently can bend themselves in half.
Yeah. I couldn't do that.
No. What was it like in the workroom in real life?
Cold. It's the coldest room I've ever walked into. Because they keep it really cold so the Queen's makeup stays on. I think Ru likes it quite cold is what I'm sort of guessing.
And that's the tea.
Yeah, that is the real tea.
Yes! Well, that must be why Bimini as Katie Price's nipples were so.
So hard. Yeah. Yes, exactly. I think your answer's like, yeah,
just
exactly.
Just keep the nipples as erect as possible in the workroom.
Yeah, you couldn't go in there in like a little vest or something.
No.
Like it's freezing.
If you did,
in the
you'd
room.
Have to just
nipple tassels, yes.
One on each.
Yeah.
But obviously, it's an iconic drag show.
Yeah.
And this season has gone off.
Yeah.
We've got our final four. BRB, by the way, we have not seen the final yet. So this discussion is taking place pre-final. Jodie, who is your favourite of the final four?
Okay, so it's between Tayce and Bimini. And they're both mates of mine, but I think they are the two. They're the two front runners as far as I can see.
I'm going to withhold my opinion because I'm, you know, going to be the best presenter that I can be and not give any opinions. But she's the queen that has shone to me as the one that you would think that would win.
Yeah.
But Ru never lets you think you know who's going to win.
You never know. And sometimes they like to sort of gag you, don't they, with the wit. Like they've been in past seasons.
It.
I thought Bag of Chips was going to win season one.
Yeah.
She won our hearts.
And also, I feel like you're a winner if you're in the final four.
You're a winner if you go on the show.
Yeah.
That's hard. I couldn't do that.
Do you not think?
No. Well, no.
Are you just a look queen? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, Jodie? I'm just a look queen. I don't barely even have that. No, I don't think, it's really tough going on Drag Race. From what I hear from people that have done it, it's like day in, day out, performing, doing really hard stuff. The limbo challenge.
Are you ready to dissect some clips, Jodie?
I think I am.
Oh my God, let's get into it. I'm so excited.
I'm like the Loch Ness Monster. A legend.
Oh yeah, did she
knock the headpiece off?
And didn't she do it again?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I think you normally just get one, you just do your one entrance.
Which I love, by the way, that they only do that. You
couldn't. Love to your copy.
Yes.
She's a national treasure.
It is finally time to spill the tea. Reveal!
Love.
It's not
love.
A reveal, sauce.
Okay, I love Ginny Lemon. She literally looks like Naomi Campbell. Sure, stunning.
Oh my God.
Love
absolute
Astina.
Stunner.
She should have stayed in longer.
Yeah. So, Jodie, we've obviously just seen all the queens enter. Who do you think wins entrance?
Oh, without a doubt, Cherry Valentine.
Oh my God.
Because I like to support the underdog. And when her piece gets knocked off, I just thought, Cherry.
She slayed messing that up.
Yeah. Yeah, we love a messy queen.
Yeah, we love a messy queen.
Snatched it. Hello, UK. I think they should have called it something else for the UK.
Oh.
I think they should have called it, it should have been blankety blank.
Yeah, but I think the snatch game element is so iconic that
the
people are just quivering in their...
To the Drag Race universe.
Yeah.
Amazing.
I didn't have time
Incredible.
To write anything.
That
Amazing.
Bit. I think standouts for me were Ahura and Bimini, but Ahura didn't get good results for Louis Spence.
I think when you do a male presenting role for Snatch Game, it doesn't go down as well, historically. Well, I think Bimini certainly deserved to win.
Oh, without a shadow.
With the Pwicey.
Yeah.
But then the judges in that were, you know, Gemma Collins.
And do you think she's a harsh judge?
That's quite a good name for her. TV show, is it?
Guess who's going to host that?
Me.
Harsh.
Yeah, me and you.
Yeah, she was quite quiet.
Yeah.
She was quite quiet, but she did say quite a lot of rude things, which I enjoyed.
Yeah.
There was a lot of dick jokes.
Okay.
Who doesn't love a penis joke?
Yeah.
Don't know if you're going to put that in the edit.
Yeah. She's had a lot of experience.
Oh! I haven't, so I won't be able to comment on that.
Well, this year, same.
Good girl, stay safe. COVID secure. So let's chat a little bit about your new single, which, by the way, is a banger, but I'm slightly upset with you because you've released it when I can't...
Dance in...
be out there.
I don't know what it was. Was that a WAP move?
Well, a little bit of WAP.
Yes.
There's a little bit of WAP there, yes, Jodie. Listen, you've given me a little bit of WAP with your new single. 61 queens.
Yeah.
And it was one video.
And yes, it was a nightmare getting everyone to send their videos
yes.
in. And there was a lot of like, hi Tayce, just wondering if you've done it yet.
But this what comes from being one of the most iconic huns in the London scene. You can just ring up Tayce and
totally.
Say,
yeah.
hun.
Yeah. Everyone said yes, absolutely, of course we'll do it. But then you're just like, how? I mean, drag queens aren't known for professionalism, to be quite honest, and like being on time and all these things. So
Tayce
like,
especially.
She's like known for, yeah. Yeah, but it all came together in the end and we have 61 queens in the video.
A beautiful queer celebration and there is nothing I love more than a queer celebration, huh?
Yeah, and I wanted to marry the world of interior design with drag queen culture.
Yeah.
Thus, it's queens at home, lip syncing in their living room.
Dismantle the patriarchy.
Yes, Bimini.
Yes, she's nailed that merch, hun.
Yeah, yeah.
Crikey. Jodie Harsh, it's been such a pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
Honestly, thank you for coming and chatting all about drag culture, but also about the show and your new single, My House, which is out now. Go stream it. And we will catch you next time, babes, when we do our own TV show together.
100%. What was it called again?
It's going to be called...
Harsh Judges.
Yeah, Harsh Judges.
We just sit around slagging everyone off.
I cannot wait. I didn't want to go straight in with a spoiler at the start in case you haven't caught up yet, but we have our Drag Race winner.
Look away now if you don't want to see them.
Congratulations, Lawrence Chaney!
Oh. Oh my God, I cannot believe it at all. It feels not real.
Babe, you deserve it. You absolutely smashed it. You were fantastic across the series. What do you think won it for you in the end?
Watching it back, the way I perceived myself looking at it was I started off very strong, but I knew what I could do and what I couldn't do. So I told myself, I said, well, Lawrence, you're a comedy queen, so you can't dance, you can't sing, you will never be OK, hun. But then I was UK hun. Michelle and Rue, I remember in the first Rusical challenge, they were like, you're not bad. You just think you're worse than you are. And then I took some time to think on it and I turned that switch off and I said, right, well, let's do this dancing songwriting thing. Let's do it. It was so nice to see me relax because I was like, okay, let's learn this choreo. So I think it could have been that progression that's got me the crown.
And I think liberating is the word I would use. That final moment, Lawrence Chaney. This is it.
Yeah. From hell to oh, there's a lamp there. They'll use that.
Listen, you talked very candidly about when you were younger and situations with bullying. And I think it's so brave of you and also very important for everyone watching to kind of be able to relate to. Is there anything that you can say to other kids that might be having similar situations or advice, I guess you would give your former self?
My main thing is I want everyone to be positive about their body or be positive about what they bring, because I beat myself up a lot for what I don't do. I don't respect, I don't take enough time to respect what I can do. The truth is you need to start, the earlier on you start appreciating your gifts, the more it's just going to naturally progress into, oh, I really appreciate that I can do that. Yeah, I'm not a good dancer, but oh, I love the way I do this. That's how it starts.
Well, honestly, congratulations. You deserve it. It's fantastic. All the queens in the final were so wonderful. So honestly, it was just exciting to get to the end. And just one quick one. Do I have to curtsy now or is it now?
How do you do a virtual curtsy? That's what we need a masterclass on. Oh. It looks like you're about to break in someone's house.
I think
that was...
Jeez. That was my burglar curtsy.
Yeah. Very classy of you. Very classy.
Congratulations, Lawrence Chaney. What do you think of UK Drag Race Series 2? If you've watched the show, make sure you at Heat with your thoughts right now. We'll be back faster than you can say the cheek, the nerve, the gall, the audacity, the gumption. And remember that taste in TV is subjective and only you can be the real judge, but that's what makes it so fun. Goodbye.